All right, so we haven't been posting in a while because we got some, like, a series of catastrophic events happen that kind of stopped all of our plans. First thing was
finding out about the building.
Yeah, so there was, like, this article in the news that our building didn't have the proper license for fire safety or something. They just never got checked. So there was, like, this rumor that the police were going to come and kick everybody out on, like, the 15th. And the 15th was, like, in how many days?
10 days,
yeah. So we'd had, like, 10 days to move. So then we were like, all right, well, let's at least take this seriously. And if we need to move, we'll have all our stuff in order. And then our visa, at the same time, was, like, coming to an end.
And they told us, they came around and they're like, oh, don't worry about it. You don't have to move. Whatever, it's fine. And then we go to try to renew our visa, and you have to register with the police where you're living. So because we were in that building, the police weren't registering us because they weren't recognizing that it was, like, legally okay to live there.
Right, right.
So we had to, and this was, like, 2 days before our visa is
2 days.
And they're already kicking a lot of people out right now.
Vietnam as a country is not taking foreigners in, but then they're also not approving a lot of people's visas. Like, people who've been here for, like, 15 years, 5 years, you know, who've, like, made a home here, and they're, like, kicking them out. And it makes sense. Like, when you really think about it, if you're on a tourist visa, you shouldn't be working. You should just come here, you know, see the sights, and then leave. But what's happening is people aren't really, they're working, they're living, and so they need another type of visa. It's the same as if you were in the States. You wouldn't be able to do that. So it's just the way that visas, the nature of visas. So it really makes sense, but it was just a shock because, you know, we've been doing it for so long.
So the next thing that happened was us trying to go to the police and get ourselves registered. Our landlord was going to go. He never showed up to do it. So we were like, okay, we'll just go ourselves. They were like, no, we're not. We can't register you if you live in this building. And our visa agent was like, well, you just have to find a new building. And we had about, like I said, 2 days to do that. We decided to ask some very, very helpful friends for their very, very helpful help. they registered us living with them, even though we didn't
really live there,
but they helped us out. They gave us a place to stay if we needed to, and basically just gave us another address to be able to register and get our visa approved.
So it's almost like we moved out briefly, and then he let us register in his apartment, and then we moved to another place. So it's almost like we moved to three places, if that makes sense. Yeah, it's just a way to register with another address, and that's what we had to do. So then after all of that, we finally moved into a solid place because we were like, if we can't register with our visa, why are we living here? Yeah, so that was a headache. And we finally got all settled in, and we're just waiting to hear whether or not we're going to get approved for our visa. So yeah, that's pretty much what happened. And I'll be sure to get on the Saigon video and what happened when we came home after Saigon. But this is just our new place, and we're really happy. And just finally back to some kind of normality or some semblance of stability. Hope to see you soon. Hope to make more video. Hope to, I don't know. Here's Nina.